And this oil requirement will rise to 90% by 2030. So our import bill will increase. At present, I think 35-40% of our total import bill is paid out on account of oil imports. And all this oil import is coming from one particular region of the world, which is not always a politically stable region. उधर लीबिया में कुछ हुआ, इधर पेट्रोल का प्राइस बढ़ गया. उधर इजिप्ट में कुछ हुआ, इधर पेट्रोल का प्राइस बढ़ गया. उधर सऊदी अरेबिया में कुछ हो जाएगा, वो कहेगा आई डोंट वांट टू सप्लाई यू ऑयल एंड पेट्रोल, गो टू हेल. व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू मैन? सो वी आर नॉट इन अ वेरी हैप्पी सिचुएशन एज फार एज एनर्जी सिक्योरिटी ऑफ आवर कंट्री इज कंसर्न. आई मीन माय ओवरऑल एम ऑफ टॉकिंग टू यू टुडे इज टू जस्ट यू नो make you aware of the larger areas. You know, I don't want to be giving you a very technology specific lecture, for which frankly I'm not even prepared, because I told our organizers friends, where is he? Yeah, so I had mentioned to him I'll only stay until lunch, and it's a measure of the success of your event that I've stayed back, because I enjoyed the first part so much. So I said I should not disappoint you, and then I felt guilty that there will be X number of students, and you know, they will feel that there is nobody to speak to them. So I stayed back. I don't have a ready presentation on solar cells workshop, what it is supposed to be. So I am giving you a general expose on solar power, but my aim is to make you feel concerned about the overall picture of our environment, because you know, we are here to talk about, this is a green summit, right? And the theme is reduce, recycle and reuse. So I want you to actually think in that direction, you know, think in the direction of how can we reduce our fossil fuel consumption, how can we recycle the material that we have, how can we reuse the solar power, so much of it which we are getting free of cost. So these are the telecom towers that I was mentioning to you. Now the flip side of it, of course, is, and all of you are engineering students, so tomorrow you will be out in the market looking for jobs. So you know, this actually opens up job opportunities, you know, for engineers. This opens up entrepreneurship opportunities, or you can actually go and set out your own little consultancy, or own little agency, or manufacturing setup, or service setup, or something, you know. Because each one of what I have told you is a business. Telecom towers and solar power for telecom towers is a business. Just apply your mind to it. 350,000 telecom towers. Half of them on diesel generator. My God. And number is increasing. Because you know, urban area they have saturated, but rural area is still to go. Rural area mein to abhi bahut juice hai. Aur dalenge wahan pe. Aur bijli bhi hai nahi. ऑब्वियसली जिस हिसाब से चल रही है अगले 5 साल तो आने वाली नहीं, तो उधर और डीजल चलाते जाएंगे. गवर्नमेंट इज अंडर प्रेशर कि भाई डीजल कम करो, पोल्यूशन बहुत हो रहा है. यू नो, प्री लंच वी हैड अ वेरी गुड सेशन बाय अवर प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम हियर, हु गेव अस अ वेरी गुड पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन व्हाई वी नीड टू रिड्यूस. यू नो, वी हैव गॉन एंड मेड सम इंटरनेशनल कमिटमेंट्स. आवर कंट्री हैज गॉन एंड मेड एन इंटरनेशनल कमिटमेंट वेयर वी शुड रिड्यूस द कार्बन इंटेंसिटी ऑफ आवर एमिशंस बाय 25% by 2020. So how can we reduce? We are growing so fast. Everything that we do, carbon emissions will happen. You do manufacturing, you do transport, you do agriculture, you do commerce. Everything involves use of energy. When energy will be used, carbon emission will happen. So are you telling me that I should reduce what I am doing by 25% so that I can go and meet your commitment? Obviously not. So there is a paradox, because I need to continue to grow, right? I am one of the poorest countries. 1/3 of my people are living below poverty line. 1/3 of my people below poverty line, and I have been growing at 8-9%. I need to continue to grow at 8-9%, perhaps 10% over the next 20-30 years. If I have to bring these people up to a certain level, you know, 80% of the population is living on $1.25 a day, which is defined as the international poverty line. $1.25 a day is very nothing. You give that much of a tip to a bearer, right? That's the per capita income in this country. So how are you going to get out of that and at the same time meet your carbon commitments? The only way to do that is you go whole hog into a different lifestyle. which will not only include use of renewable energy sources, whether it is solar, wind, bio, hydro, but also a whole lot of other things. You know, there was an extremely good lecture given in the pre-lunch session by a gentleman who came from Delhi about sustainable building design. That's a big ticket item. You know, we are sitting in a hall, outside is bright sunshine, we've created first a dark corner here, and then we've put out all the lights, and we are consuming so much electricity here. I don't want to criticize this particular organization. This is 100% of the buildings in the country you will see is like this one. We never applied our mind, look man, at least you should have windows, and during daytime, you use as much sunlight as possible, isn't it? So first we will create a dark room, and then we will use lights. But we are all grown up like this, we never gave it a thought. We never gave it a thought because we are all living as if there is no tomorrow. There is a tomorrow, man. There is a tomorrow, and we have to plan for that tomorrow. Okay, so more of these products. So like you have telecom towers, you can provide solar power for remote railway stations. There's a lot of action which is happening in the area of rural household electrification. We are sitting here in Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, you know, there's a lot of work we as a company have done. And there are other companies which are getting into this space now because, you know, electricity situation is very, very poor. Not only in UP, all around Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttarakhand, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, Haryana, Punjab not so much. But mostly in other places. Rural areas are very, very badly hit. You go to a village called Iqbalpur, which is hardly 20 kilometers out of Gurgaon. Gurgaon is, you know, the new face of India, the so-called millennium city. Shining facades, shining buildings. Huh? And 20 kilometers out of that, there is a village called Iqbalpur where there is no electricity. I mean, wires are there, fittings are there, people 20 साल से बिजली आई भी है, कनेक्शन आ गया था, बिजली आती नहीं है सर. माय डीलर हैज सोल्ड 100 सिस्टम्स इन दैट वन विलेज. सो फॉर माय डीलर इट्स अ गुड बिजनेस, बट यू नो ओवरऑल इट्स अ वेरी लॉपसाइडेड स्टोरी इन टर्म्स ऑफ द वे वी हैव गॉन अबाउट डूइंग आवर पावर सेक्टर. सो एटलीस्ट द गुड़गांव फेलो हैड एक्सेस टू दैट इंफॉर्मेशन, हैड एक्सेस टू प्रोडक्ट्स, had access to bank finance which was made available to him so that he could buy and pay back in terms of monthly installments. But the guy out there in the remote Jharkhand villages or Chhattisgarh villages doesn't even have that. Right? So, solar is a solution which works. There's a lot of this, I'll skip some. This is actually a case study of a Chhattisgarh village. What you see on the screen is a village level power plant. Okay, so solar, as I said earlier, lends itself to use at various scales. So you can have individual home lighting systems, or you can even put up a village level power plant. So what you see on the screen is a village level power plant of maybe 5 kilowatts. You just have panels on the top of a little room that you've constructed, and in the room you can put your battery bank. So you have your batteries and charge controllers and inverters and all the jig bang. And the power which is being generated by the panels on the top is going through the charge controller into the battery. The battery is getting charged during the daytime. And then from that you have wires going out into every household like a normal, you know, distribution network. So people use the power. Works very well. It's fantastic. This is one picture, but there are 900 such villages that we have done. 900. And yet, if you look at it from a country's point of view, 900 is a bloody hell, it's a drop in the ocean. Because there are 80,000 villages to do, right? 900 is just about 1% of the total market. So again, look at it in a positive way. 99% market is still to be covered. It's a business opportunity. Look at it as an opportunity. You can go out there and serve them. As engineering students, think of it as a business opportunity. There's so much work to be done in terms of going and designing the system, installing the bloody thing, commissioning, operation, maintenance, training of the staff, you know, supply chain, logistics, safety, security, data monitoring, performance monitoring, government relations, public messaging, marketing. So much to do, you know, at every node of the value chain, there are jobs. There are jobs, but you'll have to get into that. So this is one, one facet or one aspect of solar. But you know, there are many others which we can talk about. So I'll skip all this. This is a lot of details. I don't think you have time for this. Okay, so look at this. This is the map of our country, our great, great country. And you look at Rajasthan, you look at Gujarat. That's where maximum solar radiation is available. So in terms of where is the solar projects or solar business opportunity, mostly it is in Rajasthan, mm-hmm. Gujarat, but a lot of it also in Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, etc. As you can see, also in Leh Ladakh and that part of Jammu and Kashmir. The other beauty of this is that, you know, for solar power, you need, basically you need two things. You need a lot of sunlight and you need a lot of land. And in Rajasthan, you have a lot of land. You know, the desert states, desert districts of Jaisalmer, Jodhpur, Barmer, Bikaner, etc. Where, you know, non-agricultural land is available, because we wouldn't like to have solar power plants coming up on agricultural land. But on non-agricultural land, which is good for nothing else, that land is not good for agriculture, certainly not for industry, and nobody lives there. And there's so much sunshine anyway. So that's a fantastic combination. It's a God-given combination which is available to us. And now, a lot of solar power plants are coming up because of the Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission, which the Government of India has launched. I'll skip all the business. So under the solar mission, you know, there is a 20,000 megawatts kind of target which has been set out. And currently, up to 2013, there is a first phase target of 1,000 megawatts, which is now more or less going to be achieved in time. So this is one example of our country doing something in time and doing it well. So, you know, gone are the days when we used to say, hum kuch nahi kar sakte, kya nahi kar sakte, hum bhi kar sakte. We can do it now. Look at Delhi Metro. We can do it now. If we can do the Delhi Metro, we can do solar power plants also. If my company can make solar panels which are exported to Germany, and Germans are the most difficult customers in the world, you know, they are so quality conscious. You've got to be right up there to the last millimeter, isn't it? Otherwise, you'll be out. But we export over there, and every day we are fighting our battle to retain our little market share vis-a-vis the Chinese and the Taiwanese and the Japanese and the Americans. So if we can go and fight a market battle in Germany and Spain, why can't we do the same in India? Why can't we supply goods of the same standard and quality in India? Of course we can. Up to now, why couldn't we do? Because there was no policy framework. You know, you couldn't connect the solar power into the grid. Now you can. Now you have the solar mission. Now the government says, if you put your solar power into the grid, I will buy it from you. Earlier the government was not going to buy it from you. Government is not going to buy it from you, why would you sell it? Right? Okay, all this is too much for you. I'll skip all this very quickly. An introduction of my company. This is Tata BP Solar. It's a joint venture of Tata Power with BP Solar. BP meaning British Petroleum. British Petroleum, I don't know if you guys are aware, is a very large company, fourth largest company in the world. Tata Power is a part of the Tata Group, as you know. Tata is the biggest and the most respected business conglomerate in India. We've been around for 20 years now, and we manufacture solar cells. I showed you in the beginning what cells look like. And we make solar modules. I showed you what a module looks like. And then we integrate them into a solar product, like a lantern. I showed you a lantern. Or a street light, or a home lighting system, or a traffic light. So these are all the products that we make. And either we sell them in India or we export them. So this is what our solar cell manufacturing plant looks like. You know, we have a 84 megawatt capacity for manufacturing of solar cells. These are crystalline silicon solar cells. And then the cells are assembled into modules. We have got about 125 megawatts per annum kind of capacity for making of modules. And we do everything from designing, engineering, manufacturing to testing, supply, installation, maintenance and training of the solar power plants. distribution network all over India, and a range of products going from, you know, small lanterns and home lighting systems through to engineered solutions for specific businesses like banks, rural banks, telecom towers in rural areas, health centers in rural areas, highways, offshore platforms for ONGC, building integrated photovoltaic solutions, and so on. And going up all the way up to megawatt scale plants, which can be either on the rooftop of a building or in open field. So some pictures of what we've done: street lights, home lights, solar power solutions for telecoms, for off-grid. The picture on your right hand side, these two pictures are that of a solar water heater. Please understand, solar water heater is a different technology. Okay. All this while I've been telling you is about solar photovoltaic technology, whereby you are converting sunshine into electrical power, which is then being used to light up something. You're lighting up a bulb, right? So you're giving some light or a power application. But here it is simply heating of water, nothing else. It's just heating of water, it's pretty simple.